Wait, I haven't said that part.
We are so fortunate to be able to celebrate Janamstami in this Kali Yuga and of all places on earth in the USA. USA has given us so much, but let's not forget that our parents' hard work and culture instilled in them has enabled us to go further. We have most of the material comforts and technology benefits available in the world at our feet. All of this is great, but we have to understand our culture too, so that we can achieve what our parents achieved, and at the same time maintain our mental and physical health. Today we are gathered to celebrate Janamstami, and one of our goals is to revive back and correct understandings we have lost over time. One of the most misunderstood relationships in modern times is the relationship between Radha and Krishna. Look at all the painting and pictures of both of them together. In the pictures and portraits, one sees as an adult Radha and an adult Krishna. Maybe it's not intended by the artist to portray a physical romance between the two. When you look at such pictures, the thought that comes to most mind is that of the physical love between the two adults. This is furthest from the truth. Let us watch as the older children try to understand the relationship between Radha and Krishna.
Hi everyone, I like Janamstami.
Especially the little kids dancing their hearts out, best as they can. There is no inhibition in their dancing.
I love the slow recitation. Some children were timid, but they still worked hard.
Hey, I enjoy this gift. We need to give kudos to the little children.
All this is nice, and I enjoy the skit, Radha and Krishna, but I still have a question about Radha. Who is Radha?
Yes, I also have a question. We remember Radha after so many years.
When Krishna was born, a number of beings were also born. Most came before Krishna's birth.
That is true, for who does not like to play with Yogeshwar, the universal power, when he comes to earth?
So all these beings took place around physical Krishna.
Yes, they were all young. Think about children play. There is innocence and camaraderie in their play. They may fight, but soon they play again. That's the beauty of child play.
This was God's way to work with other divine beings.
So Krishna only stayed in Gokul and Vrindavan while he was a child and played with all these beings?
It looks like that, but I still do not understand Radha.
Radha is also a divine being that came to earth to be with Krishna. Remember, on the spiritual level, there's only oneness, but that is why we say Aham Brahmashmi. But various aspects of God, they come and they create multipleness.
So what aspect of God is Radha?
Radha is God's pure, unconditional, and unexpectational love.
Love? What do you mean?
Rashida, do you remember when we learned about the Atman, the real me or you? There are three essences of the Atman. One, existence. Two, knowledge. And three, love.
So the essence love of God came to earth as Radha?
Please, everyone, keep in mind, just as knowledge of God is shown through Shiv, God's love is shown through Radha.
Just like God and his love cannot be separate, Radha and Krishna are inseparable.
Now I get it, we cannot refer to God without his love. So, Krishna cannot be complete without Radha.
This is great. I get a better understanding of Krishna and Radha.
Please, everyone, keep in mind that God's love is unconditional, pure, sacred, and holy, just like Radha is pure and sacred.
So we do not read or hear about Krishna and Radha together in their adulthood, because when Krishna and Radha were together during their children, and childhood, and then Krishna left Vrindavan and never came back in his whole entire life.
We must maintain the sacredness of this relationship and share it with others.
Now that I understand this concept, I can make others understand this concept too.
It is sad that as we get older, we lose our innocence. We make everything that is pure and holy as dirty as the vast imagination of our minds.
In this Kali Yuga, we have to maintain our relationship with God so that we don't end up like those ignorant people who make baseless comments.
Yes, we have to be careful to learn a subject before we can make comments about it.
It is time for me to go, but I really enjoyed today's discussion.